Damn, son, where'd you find this?
We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. Oh, yes. For a saint is just a sinner who fell down, but we couldn't stay there and got up. Say now,
we fall down,
oh,
but we get up.
Get back
we
up.
Fall down,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
But we
Commandment 1, thou shalt not wear pink hats that say bitch on them, lace shirts with like exposed backs, or any of that gay shit y'all seeing in the beginning of the video. Why this is becoming a trend, I don't know. I blame it on niggas trying to buy NBC though. Number 2. Kicking it with your guys, right? You playing 2K, Madden, whatever, you know, Rocket League, whatever game you playing. There should not be, and I mean there should not be, more than one guy in the room with this shirt off. If it's more than two, if it's more than one, and it's like 2, 3, 4 guys in the room with their shirts off, y'all niggas gay. End of story. I'm not finna discuss that. Number 3. Giving your boy a hug. It's not gay. Let's put that out there right now. You can give your boy a hug, especially if you ain't seen him in like, you know, a year or two, whatever. You know, handshake, you know, a hug like that. But if you're gonna give your boy a hug, your arms must, and I mean must, be above the shoulders. It shouldn't be no arms around the waist. Should never be none of that. That's suspect shit. Why you got your hands around this man's waist? Your hands is almost at his ass. That's not cool, you know? Commandment 4 is, thou shalt not ever take a piss while his mans is taking a shower. Why this has to be said, I don't know, but I'm pretty sure you niggas don't know this. Because y'all wearing shirts with, not shirts, but y'all wearing hats with the word bitch on them. So y'all probably think y'all a bitch anyway. But I don't even have to explain why this is a commandment. But if you take a piss while your boy taking a shower, you gay. Fuck 12. Number 5. Summertime. You know it's hot outside. Barbecues happen. You invite your boys over for barbecues. You like, hey, come through in this barbecue. My family throwing the barbecue, real tips, chicken, you know, bacon wrap, real tips, all the good shit. And your boy's like, all right, cool, I'll be there in two hours. I gotta get ready, you know, finish some shit up around the house. You shall not make this man a plate before he comes. I should not be pulling up to the barbecue, and I see you already got my plate made, wrapped in aluminum for you. Like, hey, I already made your plate for you. You got all your favorite foods on it. First off, motherfucker, how you know my favorite foods? We don't talk about that. Second off, you took time out your day to fix my plate, even though I could do it my damn self because I'm a grown-ass man. No. Next number, 6, 7, 8. I don't know. I'm not focused. Number 6, right? Was it number 7? Oh, shit. See, I come from Chicago. They don't teach us how to count. They just teach us how to shoot. Number 6. Never sleep in your homie's bed. That explains itself. Like, why are you sleeping in his bed? I don't care if you tired. No. Don't sleep in his bed. Number 7. Never. And I don't know if people still do 3-way calls. I think we just do text messages now. But let's say you find yourself in a predicament where you are in a 3-way call with your boy and somebody else, like another dude. So it's 3 dudes on the 3-way call. That's not gay. That's not. There's just three niggas talking. Group conference call. What is gay, though, is if before you call that third person, you talk to your boy and you like, listen, I'm going to put myself on silent. I'm going to put myself on mute. I want to catch him in a lie or something. I just need to, I want to hear him say something about me behind my back. Blah, 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 you know, all that shit. That's some female shit. That's some suspect shit for a man to do. If you want to know if a dude talking about you, just ask him in his face. And if he is, you handle that like men in each other's faces. Don't, no, none of that silent call bullshit. Number 8. Now, this is not anything gay or anything or what a man shouldn't do. It's just more of a tip in life. And number 8 is never get high off your own supply. And what I mean by that is stop beating your meat all the time. That's it. Get some ass. Don't beat your dick all day. Number 9. Never tell your man's his ass look good. That's it. I seen it happen before. That's why I put it in this list. I was on Facebook, and this man, he was wearing some True Religion jeans. And I seen another dude comment, and they both straight. I seen another man comment, damn, bro, your ass look fat in them jeans. And the last and final commandment, and this is something like an add-on to the last commandment. So it's good. That goes back to back. Call me Drake. But if you and your homie decide to have a threesome with a female, instead of just taking turns like normal motherfuckers, but if y'all like, let's do a three-way, you know? Never should you ever give a compliment on this nigga's dick. You should not be hearing the shit from the back. He getting some head, right? You know, it's like that. And then you look over her shoulders, and you like, damn, homie, you got a big dick. You should never do that shit.